Cooperation is as old as humanity, and records exist for people working cooperatively right back to the 1760s. But the cooperative movement as we know it today began right here on Todd Lane in Rochdale. Life was hard in the 1840s. There were few jobs for the weavers, people were hungry, and life expectancy was very low. People were often in debt to shopkeepers, who sold poor quality food. This cooperatively owned shop was set up by 28 working people in 1844, who wanted to be able to buy honest food at honest prices. They saved up until they could afford to open a shop, and transported their first goods by wheelbarrow all the way from Manchester. This group became known as the Rochdale Pioneers. They had butter, flour, oatmeal, sugar, and candles. The gas company thought the co-op shop would not be able to pay their bills, and so wouldn't supply them with gas. So the pioneers had to use the candles to light the shop the very first opening night at 8 p.m. on the 21st of December, 1844. The Rochdale Pioneers were inspired by Robert Owen and used his ideas to create the cooperative values. Anyone could join the cooperative by paying £1, regardless of their religion, politics, or job, and each person had one vote. They sold pure goods, and the shop profits were shared with the members as dividends. After 1 year, they had 74 members, and by 1860 this had grown to 3,450 members and 6 new stores. The idea of co-ops was spreading across the country, and in 1863 the Cooperative Wholesale Society was formed, buying in bulk to supply stock to the growing number of shops. This became the Cooperative Group. Most co-ops had a reading room above the shop that members could use, as education was seen as very important for all. In the Rochdale Pioneers Cooperative, many men and women had their first opportunity to take part in voting, years before general elections were in existence. Women were welcome in cooperatives from the very beginning, given equal voting rights, and were allowed to sign for their dividend. A minimum wage was implemented in 1907, 90 years before becoming law in the UK, and cooperatives were often ahead of their time when it came to issues like pensions and working conditions. Workers at a cooperative factory in Crumpsall had a piano, library, and even a football club at work, and they were the first biscuit makers in the country to work an 8-hour day. Employees even got a wedding cake given to them by the factory when they got married. Cooperatives are famous for caring for their members, even looking after the families of soldiers by continuing to pay their salaries whilst at war and assuring them jobs on their return home. Cooperatives spread worldwide and now have 1 billion members. From bankers and grocers to snake catchers and taxi drivers, more than 120 million people now work cooperatively. From the introduction of the Fair Trade Mark in 1994, cooperatives have been committed to stocking fair trade products, helping to support millions of food growers in developing countries. The massive impact of the actions of those 28 people back in 1844 has influenced a global movement, a new way of living and working. The original shop on Todd Lane has been preserved as a museum, so you can come and find out about cooperation, share cooperative stories, and discover more about the Rochdale Pioneers. You can check out the website to have a virtual tour of the Todd Lane Museum, or come and visit in person. The Cooperative Heritage Trust has recognised the relevance of cooperation in today's society, and with your help, can continue to develop the Rochdale Pioneers Museum and National Cooperative Archive at this important time, so we can all inspire future generations. 21st century pioneers have a unique opportunity to make a significant contribution to safeguarding the future of cooperation and to improve our lives and the lives of others. It's now our time to make a difference as we move towards a brighter, more cooperative future.